Hello, Fontana. I'm your Mayor Aquanetta Warren with another City of Fontana coronavirus update. This week has shown the commitment my colleagues on the council and I have toward working closely with our San Bernardino County supervisors and our State of California Governor, Gavin Newsom. It's important that we all recognize that many changes are coming, and your patience will allow all of us to return to the lives we knew before COVID-19. I'm happy to announce that Governor Newsom is moving California into phase two of the state's reopening plan. This allows for low-risk businesses and activities to resume operations with modifications as early as Friday, May 8th. Low-risk businesses include retail, such as bookstores, clothing stores, florists, and sporting goods stores that offer curbside pickup. Not included in this gradual reopening are offices that can't work from home, seated dine-in restaurants, and shopping malls. All guidelines for these reopenings are listed on our website at www.fontana.org. As places begin to move toward reopening, please remember that this will be a step-by-step process that focuses on the safety of everyone. Businesses have the right to refuse service to those not wearing a face covering. Although the stay-at-home order is beginning to change, the order itself is still in effect. We are monitoring the evolving situation and are continuously adapting to meet national, state, and county orders, as well to meet the needs of our city. As part of the reopening plan, the county has ramped up their COVID testing. I'm excited to announce the first drive-through testing in Fontana will take place on Tuesday, May 12th at the Auto Speedway from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. The event is open to all county residents free of charge. Appointments can be made now on the county website at sbccovid19.com. We will come out of this, Fontana, but as we said from the beginning, it's what we do or don't do today that will determine how quickly we come out of it. City Hall and city facilities will remain closed, but we continue to service your needs by phone, emails, and call for services on our website. We are putting safety measures in place, such as plexiglass at all counters, sanitizer stations, and social distance signage to protect all who enter the city buildings. Facility closures are currently through Friday 15th with a possible extension. As a reminder, parks throughout the city remain open for you to enjoy: grassy areas, walking paths, and trails. Soak up the sun this weekend while maintaining at least 6 feet from others and wearing your face covering. Playgrounds, picnic shelters, parking lots, tennis courts, basketball courts, and athletic fields continue to remain closed as a way to limit exposure. COVID-19 has dramatically changed our way of life, but this is only temporary. Thank you to those on the front lines, those who keep Fontana moving forward, and those who are doing their part to minimize the spread. We will come out of this stronger and more united than ever before. We need to stay strong and stay hopeful. This day is a special day for our city. It is National Day of Prayer. Earlier today, I had the pleasure of joining some of our police department chaplains who offered prayer for our great city on the City Hall steps. Speaking personally, I want to end this message in prayer to acknowledge the National Day of Prayer. You are in your home right now, but please join me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the great progress our great city has made, and we are unified in one effort, and that is to stay safe. Just as you have taught us that we must always work for all, that is our goal and that is our promise. We thank you for these blessings, and we thank you for this day of prayer. And we thank you for all those on the front lines that make it possible for us to remain safe. In your name, amen. Thanks to all of you in Fontana. Again, I appreciate everyone's patience and support. Now let's all move on, be smart and safe.